You're right, T.A. He wants rings and nothing less. And Kobe, I remember you saying that curiosity is such a valuable trait in a player. I bet the triangle was a very intriguing offense for you to learn and grasp.
Oh, yeah. It created such a system. It's like, you know, jazz. People watch jazz musicians orchestrating. It seems as if they're freelancing. But they're freelancing with a built-in structure. You have to have structure in order to be able to freelance and create these amazing things. And the triangle gave unbelievable structure. And, you know, some of the people that I've talked to that have competed against the triangle and lost against the triangle, whether it was to us or to the Bulls, all admit about the triangle is the biggest crock of garbage. It's just you and Michael. That's, you know what? Let's have a conversation. You remember this play?
Yeah.
Okay, that play happened at the moment it happened, 2 minutes in the fourth quarter, because you knew in the first minute of the game when we ran it, you did this defensively. So we said, okay, they did that. Check. Go wait. Okay, now let's look at this action. Okay, this action, how are they playing this action? They're playing it that way. All right, check. Hold it. We'll wait.
Interesting.
Right? And so in the fourth quarter, we're able to take advantage. Why? Because we have a structure. From that structure, we know what you are doing and how to counter what you're doing. Right? There's a reason Michael can look at Steve Kerr in a timeout and say, be ready. How did he know that?
Yeah, right.
How did he know that unless he knew every time he drove middle, Stockton was coming over to help on his dribble penetration? He could have made that pass to Steve Kerr in the first quarter, second quarter, third quarter. Why did he wait?
So the opening lineup for the Heat, down low, it's Johnson and Whiteside. Dragic and Richardson, they're backcourt, and it's Magruder in at the three. And Kobe, one aspect that always stood out about your career and dedication was your work ethic. What motivated you to continue to work hard, even in your last year in the NBA, when your body sometimes would say, no more work.
Yeah, I love the process. Yeah, I love the process more than the actual game. You know, because it's a puzzle. You have to figure out how things are going to work. Okay, my ankles don't loosen up. How do I get them loosen up? Right? Contrast there. Stretch, modalities, strength training. Right? So it's a constant
puzzle. That could take hours and hours.
Yeah. Very tedious things. But it's like a quest. You're trying to figure out what's going to work. Right? It's the little challenges along the way that always kept me interested.
McGee. Yes, and it's LeBron picking up the assist. James has got 3 assists tonight.
And it just seems that every pass they make is leading to a score. Just great ball movement.
Guys are looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time taking the lid off.
Here's Whiteside. Here's Johnson. No good, unable to win this run. Los Angeles leading by 7. Here's Hart. Off target there, that would have pushed the lead to double digits. After 20 years in the NBA, Kobe, you were able to play with so many people. Who is most like you among guys you played with? Who you would have said, this guy is like-minded? Like what Derek Fisher did that category?
Yeah, Fisher's was tough. Derek Fisher was tough. Adam Morrison, actually.
No kidding.
Adam Morrison. It made practices, it drove us because he was competitive in practice. He tried to play defense and he could move laterally with the athleticism and his physical. But he was competing hard every single day. He had a lot of competitive.
You like that?
Oh, yeah. My whole team was built like that. We had a lot of guys that were temperamental. A lot of temperamental guys. That you look at and say, you know what? You're not going to win a championship with that. When we sit back and we laugh to this day, Shannon Brown and I will get together and we'll talk about the old days. We'll just look at each other and say, you know, you believe you're going to win a championship with a bunch of misfits.
But collectively, I guess you're right. There was something that obviously worked.
Yeah, we're all crazy.
Yeah.
And so, you know, when you take a bunch of crazy and you focus it on one thing, it tends to work out.
There it is, yeah.
There it is.
Another ring. Yeah. Here's LeBron. Hassan Whiteside made his last pass. From deep 3-point range, and the Lakers with another miss. Uncovered. It's the front of the rim and out.
He's got to be wondering how he missed that. We have all the space in the world.
Kobe, a lot of teams now playing a more spread out offensive style. You played with a strength form, Robert Ory. You also played with more of a twin tower feel on your roster. Which way would you lean when you think about those different styles? You like them all.
Yeah, it just depends on the personality you have.
Right.
With the personality you have, you make the most out of it.
That puzzle you keep talking.
Absolutely. Yeah. It's every puzzle is built
right.
Right. You just try to do what you can with what you have.
You like that figuring out process.
Oh, I love it.
Yeah. Even though you're the same, you've got to kind of figure out what's on your
list. You have to be able to adapt to the game. You know, and understand what the game is. It's not what you think. And as long as I'm a leader of the team can make that shift, you'll be fine with whatever it
is. Shot clock at 6. and it's in there. Ball is not set.
Good at getting into the ninth ball. You can see how confident he is on the drive.
The Heat trail by five. Johnson surveying the floor. Astro will win it. Hope you know you made a habit of studying those players who came before you, watching tape. If you could give one example of a move or a shot that inspired you by watching footage and how you were able to implement it in your game.
Oscar Robertson's baseline fallaway. Yeah.
Which was, I think that's Kobe Bryant's baseline fallaway.
Yeah, I mean, because he had great size, mm-hmm. so he would use his body. His body was falling first, just take him down to the baseline. And then raise to the top of it. And that's something I use quite a bit.
A lot.
Yeah.
Just say it's
with great effect. With great. Johnson kicks to Adebayo. That one falls coming off Johnson's feet. Now just a 1 point Los Angeles lead.
That's their third straight lead off of the six.
The pass to Chandler. On to the right wing. Ball no good. But he had gone a sensational 5-of-5 from the field since the start of the second quarter. Stolen away. Nice shot to interrupt the alley-oop attempt there. Here's James. Solid play in the low block, and that one's good. LeBron's got his third basket of the night right there.
You know, he's had better starts, obviously, but he's shaking it off here in the second.
Gets it to go. That one good from Adebayo.
Yeah, the chemistry has been terrific. Really impressed with their offensive execution.
A feed to Chandler. Over Wade. Oh, well, ball trying to break free. He finds that one off the back iron and down the court.
He's been a safety valve for them on every possession, so he could be.
And Miami calls their first time out of the game. Last time they met was in Miami.
Yeah, last time out, they sort of shot themselves in the foot with the foul trouble. That was what led to them having such an ugly scoreline.
Oh, yeah, the guys, they need to lead the way. They fought too much foul on the pitch, and then they'll be more careful.
And Los Angeles with some changes. And Stevenson's checked in for Beast. And it's Josh Hart in for Caldwell Pope. And then for Miami, Richardson comes in for Olynyk. And it's Dragic in for Tyler Johnson. And we've got an update here, so let's catch up with David Olmert.
Well, guys, Kyle had a tough upbringing in Flint, Michigan. He said they had receptions, lead in the water. It was like an urban war zone. He probably moved 14 times before I was 16. Basketball was my key. His drive to succeed in the NBA was born of a desire to escape that environment.
A tremendous work ethic, David. Thank you. No good from Dragic.
Not easy to miss a clean-looking side like that, but he managed to do it.
Lakers putting the ball around now. Hurt. And again, no good by the Lakers.
And if they know what's good for them, that's the way they'll defend against him every time he takes the ball in the three-point lane. Just impressed with the teamwork out there, setting the table for one another.
Enzo James will bring it up for the Lakers. Chandler right side. Yes, and it's LeBron picking up the assist. James has got 6 assists in the game.
Excellent court awareness. James has always had terrific instincts as a playmaker.
I'd like to give a big thank you once again to Kobe Bryant for coming by, and feel free anytime to drop by and join our broadcast.
Thank you, man. It's been wonderful. Thank you.
And you know, Chris, you and Kobe both playing from the same era of the NBA. He was showing his thoughts about current trends in the league. Do you feel it's different from when you and Kobe both played?
Oh, definitely. I mean, when you look now, I do think that the game has changed, but I just think that's great because the game is a ball.